Recently, an atmospheric scientist that led a year-long expedition in the Arctic to study sea ice melt came out with a fairly ominous warning, saying that he can't say for certain whether whether the planet has actually already hit the tipping point on climate change. The atmospheric scientist, a man by the name of Markus Rex, and he says that he still thinks we have time, but if we do have time, he says, if it's shrinking, just like the Arctic sea ice, which he has been studying for a year in the Arctic. What they found with the Arctic sea ice is that the summer sea ice is melting more and more and more each year and eventually could disappear altogether. If summer sea ice in the Arctic disappears, that is major bad news for the climate. That means, as Markus Rex says, that's the first landmine, really. Once we see that happening, we know we have hit the tipping point and there's no going back to what once was. He says, right now, Arctic sea ice is about half of what it was 10 years ago. Half as thick, half as much. It's just not there anymore. So every winter, you have less and less that freezes with it. And every summer, you have more and more that melts away. And yes, that does contribute to sea level rise, although not as much as, you know, you've seen in movies by any stretch of the imagination. But it does reduce valuable habitat for endangered species. It increases emissions trapped in the sea ice. Overall, has a major negative impact on the climate. But we have to take the hope. We have to take the hope part of the message that we may still have time. Let's not forget, folks, it was in 2018, when that story came out that said we got 12 years till 2030 till we pretty much hit the point of no return on climate change. And at the time, we had 12 years. 3 years have ticked by. 3 years. Last year, reports show that even with the pandemic, global CO2 levels actually increased. So even the pandemic didn't stop our emissions. We have to get serious about this because, yes, we do have time. But I think at this point, and I think a lot of scientists at this point think that 2030 is being a little too generous. If we do not stop this, if we cannot reverse it now, we may run out of time. And then we're dealing with a whole new threat of climate change. Not just the extreme weather events, but as Al Gore correctly pointed out in An Inconvenient Truth all the way back in 2006, the migrants, the fights over resources, things like that, the things that people aren't even thinking about when they think of climate change. You know, the global threat that emerges as a result of people fighting over resources, which is what has fueled most conflicts throughout the course of human history. And we could be barreling headfirst into that because we're not reducing our emissions. It's a pretty selfish way for humanity to end, but it doesn't have to end that way. We have time, we can reverse it, but the clock is ticking and it's getting a lot faster each year that passes.